Hi again. This video is part of the series where I show how to use asdoc, a program to send Stata output to MS Word. In this one, I would like to show how to create nested regression tables. A nested regression table is creating a table that has multiple regression models in one table. For example, look at this one. This is a table that I have created with asdoc. The paper was published in Journal of Corporate Finance, volume 44, Judicial Efficiency and Capital Structure. So I would like to show how to replicate table 3 in this paper using asdoc. I'll start with very simple command, and then I'll gradually add different statistics and different text with it. As you can see, we have used 9 models in table 3, and there are industry and year dummies which we are not reporting in this table. Rather, we are adding a text that they were included in the tables. So let's have a look at the data that we used for this specific. The data has almost 300,000 observations. The first command that we estimated for in this paper was to start with the long-term debt and that is creditor rights. So let me estimate this regression. Okay, so actually this is the coefficient of creditor rights minus 2.7, which is reflected in the paper, that is minus 2, minus 0.02, and we are not reporting any other statistics with it. So if I were to send this output to MS Word, I would just add simply asdoc is a prefix to this command asdoc, and I would also add replace to replace any existing file that has a similar name in the current directory. So if I estimate this, the same regression is it says that replace is not allowed. Perhaps I forgot to add L. So okay, so the same regression is re-estimated, which also shows that we do not need to run separate regressions. Rather, we can send the output and estimate regression in one go with adding asdoc as a prefix to the Stata commands. As you can see, this specific option is the regress option, cluster standard errors, and replace is asdoc option. So you don't have to worry, all options have to be added after comma, whether they belong to Stata specific command or they belong to asdoc. Now the file, the first regression output is written to our file, and it writes a detailed table of regression where we have coefficient and we have some additional statistics. But we do not want a detailed regression table, rather we want a nested regression table. So instead of detailed regression table, if I add NEST, that is I want a nested table, so it will create a compact table, and a replace again will replace the existing file. Now if we look at the output again, we can see that much of the details have been cut down. Only we have the coefficient and we have standard error of the coefficient for each of the included independent variables, which include dummies and everything else. and we have two additional statistics, that is observation and R square. Again, we do not want to report all these coefficients, we want to just report the first coefficient. So I would add one more command, one more option, and that is to drop all coefficient related to industry dummies and related to year dummies. So I would add an option drop, and IND 1 to IND 60 means that all dummies starting with IND from 1 to 60 and dummies for year from 1 to 16 all have to be dropped from the output. They will be included in the regression, but they will not be shown in the output. Now if I estimate this again, now the output that we get is much smaller. All those additional details related to year and industry dummies have been removed. We can add, of course, some more options to make the table look like. For example, if I want that the column header is shown as CR instead of the name of the dependent variable, so I will add CNames CR. This should be a single word. Now let's see what changes. So the column title is now CR. Similarly, we can add other title when we add more regression models to the existing table. So far we have similarly, if I want specifically any decimal points, I'll add DEC 3. By default, 3 decimal points are shown, but if I want 4, I can write 4. And if I want my result to be written to any specific file, by default the file name is myfile.doc, but if I want that the name of the file should be JE instead of myfile.doc, I can add save. So right now I'm okay with the default decimal points. I will not change that. And similarly, one more thing, in the regression table we have written industry dummies yes and year dummies yes. If I want such additional text, these we can use the add option, and in the brackets we will specify this is the legend in this industry dummy, and this is the additional text. In front of this will be shown each word is separated by a comma. So now let's re-estimate this regression again and see what happens. Now instead of the file myfile.doc, now the file name is je.doc. And we have this additional text, industry dummy and year dummy. Now if we want to add additional regressions, we can add more results to it. For example, this time I have instead of CR, my dependent variable is IJE, and all those independent variable, FS is to have font size of 8 for the output file, and I have all other option copied from the above command, and the CNAME this time is TID, and the file name that to which I write is JE, and again I'm adding nest command to this. I can also add append if I want to, but append is optional. By default append is assumed if replace or append are not used. So now let's estimate this model again, and now since we have now nested two models, the font size, as you can see, has changed to 8. Previously it was 10 by default. Now we have one model where the dependent variable was CR, and we have another model where the dependent variable is TID. Sorry, that was IJE, and the column names. Now we can add more and more columns to the regression. Our next model is we combine both the coefficients, both the independent variable in one model. Let's see how we can do that. So this is our third regression model where dependent variable is long-term debt and judicial efficiency and creditor rights. Both the variables are added to the same model, and this time we will name the column as TIDCR. So run this model again, and we can see that the third model has the coefficient of CR and coefficient of IJE. Previously these were blank, and again the industry and year dummies are added. Now let's keep on adding more. See, now we have added some macro variable. In fact, what I can do is to select all these and estimate all of these in one go. Some of the command might take a little bit time. Now all the regressions have been estimated. If we have more regressions than what the current page width can accommodate, we can click inside the table, and on the layout we can select auto fit to window. So now we have a nicely formatted regression table. I hope that helps. For more options related to asdoc, please click on the relevant videos from the playlist. Thanks, and of course you can visit our website fintechprofessor.com, where we have lots of more Stata programs and lots of helping videos and blog entries. For example, in Stata programs you can see the full asdoc option, where the full table of content is given, that shows where asdoc can be used. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.